everyone, and welcome back to Vinto's Vault here on the Retrochat Podcast YouTube channel. I noticed that my uploads have been very sporadic, and I'm hoping to go back and do one every fortnight now, rather than trying to do one a week. I think it seems to go a little bit better then, gives me more time to create content and get videos uploaded and things like that. So hopefully that'll be something that you like. Remember as well to follow us on the likes of social media, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitch at Retrochat Podcast, and then obviously on Twitter at Retrochat Pod. So yeah, this is going to be a new series for me to do. Whereas I notice I've talked a lot about movies, and kind of wanted to continue that trend, but kind of do something different and do like a movie versus movie. And what better way to do it than with the Skywalker saga? Obviously here we've got 9 films to talk about, but we're only going to talk about 6 of them, because I don't think it's fair to pitch the original trilogy against any of them, because the original trilogy would probably win. So instead we're going to do the prequels versus the sequels. So that's episodes 1 to 3 against episodes 7 to 9. So that means that today we're going to be talking about The Phantom Menace against The Force Awakens. Now, obviously, both of these have their good points, both of these have their bad points. I do understand as well that, you know, with Star Wars, a lot of people have their opinions and things. This is my opinion on it, so it's not gospel. It's just my opinion on the film franchise that I love probably the most out of any film franchise. I know people like Lord of the Rings, people like The Matrix, people like Star Wars, Star Trek. So I just thought I'd do this. Hopefully Andy and I will talk about all the Star Wars stuff at some stage way down the line. But yeah, I just wanted to talk about this. So obviously with The Phantom Menace, this came out in 1999. So this was 16 years after Return of the Jedi first came out. And then with The Force Awakens, this came out in 2015. And this was 10 years after Revenge of the Sith came out. So both of them, you know, like obviously with this one here, we had like longer to wait. We didn't think we were going to get that. So obviously we have the likes of Anakin Skywalker, a very young Obi-Wan Kenobi, Qui-Gon Jinn, and Queen Amidala, Padme Amidala, whatever you want, the way you want to call her. And then this one here, obviously we have the returning cast of Princess Leia. Very, very late, we have Luke Skywalker, we have Han Solo, Chewbacca, C-3PO. Obviously we have C-3PO in The Phantom Menace as well. But we have new characters in here with the likes of Rey, villain Kylo Ren, and obviously likes of Poe Dameron and Finn, who's a stormtrooper. So yeah, so what do I like about both of them? Well, obviously with us here, I adore Ewan McGregor. Obviously we're coming up to the Obi-Wan Kenobi series, and you know, whenever these first came out, these, very much like the sequels in my opinion, are lambasted by a lot of fans and they don't care for them. And this was the same with episodes 1, 2 and 3, is that they were not liked at all, and it only seems to be now that people are starting to appreciate them a bit more. I know my girlfriend Karen adores episode 1 and watches that probably more than any other Star Wars movie, as you know, is fine to do so. With The Force Awakens, obviously you had a lot of the, it seems to be every generation, you know, you had the original Star Wars in the late 70s, early 80s, you had the prequel trilogy in the late 90s, early 2000s, and this here in the 2005, and 3 years, 2008 to 2012-ish, I want to say, for the last one, which is weird to say. But yeah, so with both of them, you had to spend so much time. But like I say, with the likes of The Phantom, with the likes of The Force Awakens, I think it hits a bigger nostalgia note, because you have the likes of Han Solo, you know, like whenever they brought out the trailer and had the Chewie We're Home line, it was huge, you know, t-shirts galore, memes galore, etc. And I think, you know, watching that for the first time, I think I watched both of them in the cinema about 5 times each. I watched The Force Awakens 3 times on opening day at midnight, 1 o'clock and 8 o'clock. And I think with the Phantom Menace, I think I just watched it on the opening day once and then watched it a couple of days, you know, thereafter. So yeah, so both of them I've seen in the cinema. I enjoyed whenever I came out of the cinema. But the Phantom Menace, whenever I first watched, the more I watched it, the more I was like, right, I need to stop watching this now. Whereas the Force Awakens, I enjoyed it more each time I watched it. So whenever I first watched them, it's like it was like that. But obviously, we have spoilers. If you haven't seen either of these movies, then why are you watching this? Obviously, we have big character deaths in Phantom Menace and The Force Awakens. But the Phantom Menace one was actually spoiled for me before it actually came out. And it wasn't through any form of social media. It was to do with CD, which I'll touch on in a minute. And then, obviously, so Qui-Gon, played by Liam Neeson, Northern Iron Jedi, and then obviously in Force Awakens we have Han Solo dying by the hands of his son Kylo Ren. Yeah, so a very different polarizing things there as well. But I think they were ready to kill Han Solo off in Return of the Jedi, and then they didn't, and then kind of it happened here. But I'm glad that he came. Yeah, he was able to come back. The only thing sad about the sequel trilogy is that we never saw the three or four of them. We didn't see Han, Leia, Luke and Chewie together, which I think would have been good to do. And I think there were so many different variations on that. But yeah, so what's good about this here, like I've said, Ewan McGregor for me really stand out. Obviously Liam Neeson is really good as Qui-Gon. Obviously, we have Jake Lloyd as Anakin Skywalker, and, you know, he's a child actor, and unfortunately, you know, like, after this, he kind of quit acting and stuff. You've probably seen him in the likes of Jingle All the Way as well. Obviously, we have an epic lightsaber fight between the main protagonist, Darth Maul, against Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon, culminating in Qui-Gon's death. I remember watching it and loving the pod race, but now it seems to be every time I watch it, the pod race seems to get longer and longer. And it's something that I kind of care for a little bit, but not the 7 or 8 minutes that it's on screen. So obviously the lightsaber fight is really good. There are certain bits of dialogue that obviously George Lucas, being the way he is, you know, whenever Qui-Gon's trying to explain midichlorians to Anakin, it's just very, I was wondering, what are midichlorians? And then, you know, they're like microscopic germs that live inside us. And it's like, they live inside me. And it's like, oh, you don't really need to explain it. Just let it be. It's fine. The extras on this are really good as well. You have a documentary called The Beginning, which basically shows you how they get the cast together. The likes of Ewan McGregor getting his hair cut. Jake Lloyd. He's doing his audition, and I actually think one of the other kids was better. Liam Neeson and Ray Park, they're both fighting each other. Another awful thing about this is, I'm going to see if I can put a picture in, is I remember watching this in the cinema and seeing this Yoda, and how you make this worse than the puppet from like the 80s, you know, the one that we all loved, and make it look like this. Obviously then, whenever they brought out it on Blu-ray and stuff, they changed it to this because they did the CGI of it. So obviously it was a lot better. But yeah, that original Yoda is horrible. So yeah, so that's what I like and kind of don't like about it. With The Force Awakens, I love the fact that we get the likes of Han in the Millennium Falcon. I love the fact that we get new characters as well. As we do in The Phantom Menace. One thing I don't like about it is the whole Death Star thing. You know, it's as much as it's maybe a necessity to have that component there, at the same time it does feel like, why didn't you just use something else instead of that, that we're going for another Death Star, but this one's bigger. It's like, oh well, you know, there's always a bigger fish, as they say. But yeah, but it's just, this is one that, because I went to see it with my father, with both of them, because my dad really liked Jar Jar, which he wasn't, you know, like, I was the younger one of the two of us, and he found him funny. He was like, Dad, no, no. We also do have, like, some documentaries on this, which has Secrets of the Force Awakens, I think it is. And you do have the likes of Gwendolyn Christie, who plays Captain Phasma, Harrison Ford, Daisy Ridley, all talking about the film. J.J. Abrams obviously brings back some other people as well. You know, we have Nine Numb from Return of the Jedi in this one. There isn't much that I don't like about this movie, to be honest with you. It is one that I can watch time again. The only thing I kind of don't like is the fact that we kind of get teased as Finn to be the Jedi. You know, like obviously all the posters kind of alluded to that. And then obviously it's Rey, and that's fine. But how she comes, very powerful lightsaber battle with Kylo Ren, and then it kind of just finishes. That's... You know, I kind of have gripes here and there. Another thing that is wonderful is the fact that John Williams does the music for both. So obviously, you know, he was in, what, 80, late 80s whenever he did The Force Awakens, which is phenomenal. Yeah, so you can see here, track 15, if you can see, is Qui-Gon's Noble End. So that's obviously how I found out that he died in that. Obviously, the Jewel of the Fates is the key track on this here. The music is very good in this, don't get me wrong, but again, The Force Awakens, for me, has better music. The likes of Torn Apart, where Han Solo dies, March of the Resistance, Rey's theme especially is just, oh, I love that music so much. And for John Williams to do this and bring this out, there is a lovely... extra to do with John Williams and to do with, you see J.J. Abrams, you know, like whenever they're recording the music, and you could just see the smile on his face because he's a Star Wars fan and he's just seeing the maestro at work, that's what I was trying to say, with doing this music here. But yeah, it's just a really iconic music as well. Obviously, we bring out music to do with the Falcon, wherever Rey and Finn run into that. Obviously, we have droids in both of them. We have BB-8 more in Force Awakens. We see R2-D2 at the end, and obviously, we see R2-D2, you know, he's to be commended for saving a ship, and he's to be cleaned up and stuff. So, out of the two of them, obviously, I could sit here for hours talking about, you know, Star Wars, because I love Star Wars so much, and I love the music of Star Wars so much as well. You know, which one would I prefer? It's a close one, because Phantom Menace is one that's been slowly creeping its way up my list. But I would have to say, out of the two of them, Force Awakens would be one that I would go for more. I just like the fact that we have the original characters come back. Obviously, with this, it's been before the original trilogy. So we do have the likes of Obi-Wan. We do have the likes of Yoda, who I've showed you. you know, like, and then in this one here, we have the likes of, say, Chewie and Han Solo and Princess Leia and C-3PO with a red arm. And there's explanations of that to do with the comic book, which I thought was a really rubbish way to explain how he got the red arm. But again, they probably did that because then they'd be able to sell more toys because C-3PO has a red arm, whereas everywhere else, he's just all gold. That's why he probably had a silver leg in the latter stages of this here as well. But yeah, both are great. Obviously, I do have this in Blu-ray with the Skywalker saga, and same here, but it's just easier to show this. This one here was actually set that I picked up in Asda, I think for about £13, shortly after it was released, and I really do like the box of it as well. And you do have a DVD, and you know, like you have the Blu-ray, you have it on DVD, and you have the bonus disc as well, but you also have J.J. Abrams doing the commentary over it, which I haven't really, not really keen on watching commentaries, but I really like the look of this here. So in terms of, you know, if I was to compare the two in the front, you know, obviously this is just that, and this is not there, but yeah, obviously a bit different with the collector's edition and just the DVD. But again, with the DVD, you just get the two disc and then the nice little insert there. But with the likes of villains as well, obviously we have Kylo Ren in this one, we have Darth Maul in this one. Darth Maul, obviously, spoilers again, and gets killed off in this, but obviously we see him in the likes of Star Wars Rebels and the Clone Wars. And then in this one here, we have Kylo Ren, who is the godson of Darth Vader. So, yeah, I preferred him with his mask on rather than his mask off. But in this one here, I actually preferred General Hux as a villain over Kylo Ren. And you see, that's a controversial take, because whenever I came out of cinemas, I actually preferred Hux as a villain over Kylo Ren. But that's just my opinion on it. But yeah, so story-wise and stuff, like I say, you know, I think both are easy to watch. You know, like if you're bored and you just want to stick on a DVD, then either of these, or Blu-ray, either of these, or Disney Plus, either of these are easy enough to watch. And if you want to see the start of a trilogy, you know, you go from either one of these and work your way through. The next one's going to be interesting, because both of them are my least favourite Star Wars movies. So it's going to be interesting to see which one triumphs. Will it be Attack of the Clones, or will it be The Last Jedi? Well, you're going to have to come back and find out about that. But let me know down in the comments below what you prefer, The Phantom Menace or The Force Awakens. There may be reasons why, you know, like The Phantom Menace could be the first Star Wars movie you ever watched. Same way, The Force Awakens, you could be a late arrival to the Star Wars universe, and this could be the first one you watch. So let me know down below. Head over to our Facebook page, interact with us there on Instagram and stuff. And yes, I'll be back in a couple of weeks with Attack of the Clones and The Last Jedi comparison. It's, I think, going to be a really, really long video, because I'm going to be saying so many bad things about them. Or it's going to be a really, really short video, because I'm not going to have much good to say about them. But we'll wait and see. But yes, thank you very much for watching, as always, and until next time.